sick collector, compulsive collector, and I wanted to collect everything in the specific field of this relationship, visual art and sound in the 60s and 70s. First of all, you can imagine that it's going to be terribly boring to see 800 records, one after the other, one after the other, on 600, 700 meters. So I had to conceive the exhibition to give it a kind of variety that it doesn't get boring. So I created groups, or monographic groups, or by style. And for example, here we are standing in front of a whole wall related to sound experiences and works related to sound, on the image of sound from the Fluxus movement. But there's also a group about sound poetry, there's a group about the relationship pop music and visual arts, so I try to move this around. We have a very nice collection of Solowit, who was working for Philip Glass, as they knew each other very well. I think it was a pleasure for them, and there's a wonderful relationship between the typical image of Solowit and the repetitive music of Philip Glass, which is not the case, for example, of Andy Warhol, where there's no relationship between the image and the contents of the record. It's only an illustration, like years before they could make the face of Frank Sinatra on a record, except that this is in the style of Andy Warhol. All the pieces in the exhibition I collected day by day when they were published. So it's my, and I think you have to collect, or you have to be interested in the art of your time. And my time is the 60s and 70s. Now I'm an old man, and I don't want to look young by collecting music of today. It's perhaps a mistake, but it's my attitude.